Hi, Robert here from tmile.com, and in this video I'll show you how to install and set up a backup solution for your WordPress website using UpdraftPlus. The first thing you need to do, as usual, is to search for UpdraftPlus with no space between words and install the first plugin returned. Activate it, and then a new option will be found in the settings menu named UpdraftPlus Backups. Click on that link. The next screen will be the user interface, clear and friendly, with all the necessary options like Backup Now, Restore and Clone Migrate. The last one, called Clone Migrate, might be useful if you plan to move your WordPress website to another host or domain name. First things first, we go to the Settings tab and choose the File Backup Intervals. If you write one or more articles every week, I suggest you to set file backup intervals as weekly and set to retain 3 backups for this. You can also choose from the drop-down menu to do backups manually and all the way down to monthly automatic action. It's your choice. Set the database backup as well, then choose the include in files backup to be plugins, themes, uploads and any other directories found inside WP content. So leave this for checked and move to the remote storage options. There are 15 options like UpdraftPlus, Vault, Dropbox, FTP to save your files on your own server, Amazon, etc. Some of them are available with the free version, but for the UpdraftPlus, Vault, you'll need at least a premium plan. If you choose no remote storage, then the backups remain on your own server. This is not recommended unless you plan to manually copy them to your computer, as losing the server would mean losing both website and the backups in one event. I'll stick with the Dropbox option for now because it's the easiest to set up and we all use Dropbox, right? Feel free to add a comment below this video if you want me to create another tutorial about other options available. And by the way, if you are new here, please hit the subscribe button. This way you'll be notified about every new tutorial right when it's published. Moving forward, click on Dropbox from the options here and scroll down until you see the Authenticate with Dropbox link. Click on that link, then you'll be redirected to a new window with an authentication option to Dropbox. Click the Sign in with Google big blue button, then choose the Gmail account which is connected to Dropbox. Click Allow, Allow again and complete the setup process. The information above confirms that you are all set and your Dropbox account is connected, with details about the quota usage. Don't forget to hit Save Changes every time you change something here. Now you can hit the Backup button. Check all the boxes in this pop-up window, then hit Backup Now. No need to wait until the backup process is complete, because this process is running independently in the background. You can even log out, and will take some time depending on how big your WordPress is now in matter of space usage. Furthermore, you are free to play around with any advanced tools here. The current status shows you that the backup started is already running, and after some time will be completed, so you can access the existing backups in this tab. To be sure everything is okay, check for the backup files in your Dropbox account. They are in a safe place now, and from the WordPress dashboard you can restore, delete or view the log.txt file. Now you are able to restore your WordPress website anytime something goes wrong. And you should definitely check the premium extensions and sign up for a plan in order to get additional and enhanced remote storage locations, activate the cloning and migration option, request fast and personal support and much more. Thanks for watching. Please check out our latest tutorials about WordPress plugins, themes and more. Please share them if you like what you see, hit the like button and ask any question in the comments section below. Help us inform you about new uploads by hitting the subscribe button right here.